So I'm Dr. Kevin Hall. I'm at the National Institutes of Diabetes, Digestive, and Kidney Disease here at the National Institutes of Health.
Okay.
My favorite part of my job is being able to come into work and work with a diverse team of folks, all focusing on an important problem.
So, hey guys.
Hey.
What are you guys up to? Just checking out some of our results from the model.
One of the unique features about being at the NIH is that we can both do sort of more basic research on, you know, for example, computational modeling, and then use that model to design new clinical experiments, which we can also conduct or collaborate with folks at the clinical center to actually test our model predictions and basically improve our understanding of the overall system.
I'm a postdoctoral fellow, and I'm working with Dr. Kevin Hall, and we're working on an obesity study looking at diet. As most people know, obesity has been on the rise, and one of the questions is, what's the best way to lose weight? And our study is looking at taking two nutrients, reduced carbohydrate versus reduced fat, while keeping the protein the same, and seeing how it affects the metabolism, because people want to know, what kind of diet should they be on?
Food availability per capita in the U.S. has gone up by 1,000 calories a day per person since the 1970s. And we've only ate about 250 of those extra 1,000 calories. I think it's a really interesting question is, why didn't we eat more of that extra 1,000 calories? In fact, we've wasted the 750 calories. So in fact, food waste has gone up by 50% since the 1970s.
So essentially what we're trying to do is create a tool that's inexpensive and easy to use. So that all you have to do is measure somebody's body weight, and then you can figure out how much they change their energy intake by. So what these plots are is sort of the analysis of the results from our model. And what we're doing is we're comparing it to data from an actual clinical study where we know exactly how much these people were eating. So we can sort of validate the model in that manner.
We're in the patient's room right now on the metabolic unit. This is where they stay for their 2 weeks. And this is a test of resting energy expenditure. We measure the patient's breathing for about a 15 to 20 minute period. And what we do is we measure the ratio of CO2 production to oxygen consumption. And from that, we can get an estimate of what their resting energy expenditure is. And we could also get an estimate of the RQ, or the respiratory quotient, which will tell us what macronutrients specifically they're burning.
I've learned a lot so far, just the 2 days that I've been here.
You got another several days
right.
left, right?
Right. Just the 2 days that I've been here, I've learned a lot about my body, and being as though both sides of my family are heavy on diabetes, they wanted me to try to lose weight to make it better for me, and just to be healthy so nothing won't happen because I have two little boys.